Hey, what's going on, my friends, and welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Victor, and today I'm going to share with you five things I think you should know about this very powerful and transformative upcoming solstice we have on June 21st, of course, of 2022. It's a very energetically potent time, abundant, very abundant with opportunity to truly become a new version of yourself, to let go of the past and step into the new in a very noticeable and, I want to say, thrilling and exciting sort of way. Number one, you might find yourself refining your goals, thinking about, contemplating where you want to put your focus, where you want to go, where you want to put your energy and intention into. It may have been one thing like a week ago, and you were sort of set and thought, oh good, I don't have to think about this anymore, but all of a sudden life is showing you different types of evidence that's making you say, why do I feel pulled in this other way? I thought it was gonna be this, but now I feel pulled to do this. And that might change again too, but you might find yourself almost like life is revealing to you more of the puzzle, more of the picture, so you can make a more conscious choice into where you wanna go in life. And I'll give an example. I have been wondering, what am I gonna do with this YouTube channel of mine? I have bounced back and forth through many ideas. I thought about just continuing to do these energy updates once in a while. Thought about coming back full force, but that didn't feel right. And then I was driving, we're in Sedona right now, we were driving here, my wife was driving and I was on my computer and I was planning out a YouTube video. And then this YouTube video sort of plan, which normally for me is a few little cliff notes, it became this whole long thing. It became more like a chapter of a book. And I was like, wow, this desire to express myself creatively in a new way on YouTube is turning into a book. And I was really excited about that. And I still plan to write the book. But then yesterday, last night, I met this other guy, this other YouTuber, you might know him, named Kyle Cease. He's actually a really awesome dude. He's a comedian that became a spiritual YouTuber. Super cool dude. And I was watching his channel this morning, just trying to check him out because I just met him. And I noticed how his videos are very some of them are just him with his phone, real just chill, and some are really nice, and it's kind of all over the place, and I like that. I like the creative freedom Kyle had, and that gave me some renewed inspiration to also make YouTube videos. I just filmed three YouTube videos sort of on the fly. So my point is be flexible. Allow the universe to show you your potential, the most ideal way to channel your creative energy, and don't be too quick to just say, okay, this is who I am, and this is what I do. The search is over. The search is never over. The universe is always showing us that, you know what? You don't know yourself as good as you think you do, because you're more than you could ever know logically. So just be present, be fluid. And if we can be fluid and adaptable, we can just sort of find ourselves in this totally new situation with almost a totally new outlook on life and outlook on ourselves. Number two, one of the ways in which you will be getting information about what I was just saying is you will find that you have much lower tolerance for incompatible vibrations. Maybe for a while you've had a job and it wasn't your favorite job, and you didn't necessarily, feel close with the coworkers. But all of a sudden you might go into work and realize, I can't handle this physically. My body is physically failing on me from the stress and just the generalized incompatible energy I'm constantly putting myself into. I can't tolerate it anymore. It's driving me crazy. It's sucking the life out of me. That's kind of an extreme example. What I noticed recently, a few days ago, when my family and I were driving from Austin, Texas to here in Sedona, it's like a 15-hour trip over the 2 days, is I could really feel the collective energy of the different cities we drove through. I'm not gonna dog on any cities, but there was just one place that we stopped for overnight because it was kind of a bigger city, and we found like a nice Airbnb, and man, it just, I could just feel it. I just felt like this is just not my place. I felt it physically. I felt almost like the collective negativity was hard to, keep at bay. That night when I went to bed, I had these crazy, scary ass nightmares. And it was just like, I just had to get out of there. It wasn't my vibe. It wasn't a bad vibe, but it just wasn't for me. But in the past, me and my family, we'd travel, we'd gone all over the country, many times over. And we'd have our preferences, but nothing like what we experienced recently. It was like, we can't stay here. Even though it's so convenient, because it's halfway, we can't do it again. We're gonna have to just figure out something else. And you might find that same intolerance in your own way because your own vibration has raised quite a lot. And when that happens, it means you need to refine things within your life. And when you do, that's when you can really thrive and really get to embody a new level of yourself, a new octave of life. Number three, it's a great time to allow the magic back in your life. As we were driving to Sedona on one of the days, I saw something I used to see all the time. It was like an orb, as I would put it. It was like a little flash of light that just sort of appeared and disappeared. That doesn't seem from this world. It wasn't like an actual light. It was brighter, more brilliant. Sometimes green and blue and indigo and white. Anyway, I saw this orb, and what came to mind was the realization of my own, but maybe to your own surprise, but my own like skepticism and like cynicism towards the magic in life. I know it sounds kind of weird, but I realized I had this like resentment for that kind of stuff because I used to follow it so wholeheartedly. And I came to a point in my spiritual journey where it took me as far as it can go. And I had to really kind of come into my own power for a several year like span and process. But I just realized and like, wow, I'm still bitter about that. I was, 'cause at the time when I was like flipping through the tarot cards and praying and trying to astral project my way out of my problems, I found that what I really need to do is get a freaking job. What I really need to do is fix my relationship. What I really need to do is be a human being and not try to, vibrate myself off the planet to escape my problems. So in that process, it was necessary. It was a maturity phase I had to go through, a humbling. I left it though with this like, almost like, it was like an overcorrection. I become so trusting in my own self that I don't even let the magic of the universe be there to help me when it wants to. So that was my little awakening in that regard. And since sort of becoming aware of that without really even having any formal intention to reacquaint myself with the magical world of the universe, I've experienced a lot of cool unfoldments. And one of them was, I don't know if I mentioned it already or in this other video, I met this other YouTuber named Kyle Cease yesterday at the park with my kids. And he's like this awesome dude. And it was just so synchronistic the way we met, and just this short conversation just inspired me so much. And it's just like the timing was so crazy. And it was like, wow, the universe does unfold in this perfect synchronistic way. But my cynicism was sort of blinding me to the magic that's always been there. So hopefully you too can broaden your receptivity to the awesomeness and the benevolent nature of the universe. And number four, I wrote down purging fear. In fact, I made a whole new earlier today. I filmed a whole other video about that, and I'll put it up on the channel pretty soon. But there just seems to be a fear purge taking place, at least in my life. I'd be very curious to hear your thoughts. But initially, I found myself very anxious, very worried, you know, that kind of energy, which of course is just a surface level manifestation of something deeper. And I just have been having a lot of self-discoveries about where this fear that's been running a lot of my life came from. And of course, it comes from many areas. It comes from society. It comes from being immersed in our parents' vibrational auras and fields from the time in the womb even. And it just comes from the pains we experienced in life. And all of this is accumulated to this sort of generalized, fearful, untrusting outlook on the world. And it's become also an overcorrection, where we are anxious in circumstances that only maybe slightly resemble something that happened in the past, our guard goes up. Because there's a blue flower, and blue flowers, I saw one time when this bad thing happened, someone dropped a plate on my foot, and there's a blue flower, so now all of a sudden blue flowers mean bad. No. But yes, that's sometimes how we go through life, and it can be almost disturbing when you realize that about yourself, but also liberating, because you can see the logic in it. Oh my goodness. Blue flowers are very cool looking. What's the deal, Vic? And just that awareness. The awareness that the present, the past does not equal the present. That the world, the way our life unfolds, is so dynamic. It's so unpredictable that we don't have it all figured out. Our mind tries to keep us safe in all these circumstances, but it is a very fragmented and limited way of going through life. And this sort of fear energy, if you feel it, it's an opportunity to reevaluate it. And do I really need to be concerned and afraid? Don't I trust the universe? I thought I did. I do. Oh, wait, I do. I do trust the universe. In fact, it's proved it to me countless times that it always works out, that I'm always heading in a better direction. Remind yourself of that. Also, you might even go a little deeper and see, oh my goodness, I can see where this all came from. You start to see the connections. What comes to mind is this song by one of my favorite bands, Tool. The song is called Fear Inoculum. It's a badass song. And it's about how humanity, from various different, you say needles or syringes, have been injected with fear. This fear, it's contagious. We pass it on. It's like part of the collective energy that we just sort of incarnated in. And so much of it is like, it's just false. What is fear? False evidence appearing real. From you 12 steppers, know what have heard that before, I'm sure. False evidence appearing real. This fear, it really isn't, it has a place, obviously. If we're getting chased by a jaguar, fear can help us run faster and make a smart choice. But most of our life, there's no jaguar. It's all just phantoms, all just in our head. And there's so much fear, we feel it over nothing now. And we're living in a time, generally, of course, there's crazy stuff going on, but generally, we are safe. I'm safe. I'm in my backyard. I'm in an okay neighborhood, safe neighborhood. This thing could have collapsed on me, maybe, unlikely. In this moment, I'm good. So why do I feel so afraid? You might start noticing that. You might start asking yourself that. You might start catching yourself being afraid when it doesn't make sense to. And that is the stepping out of these fear energies that may have controlled you for a long time. Maybe it prevented you from doing things you felt inspired to do, but you would freeze out of this fear that you can now see through. And number five, stepping into a higher vibrational version of yourself. A good example I've shared many times, my best friend in the whole world, Aaron Dowdy. He set the stage for him to do his first live in-person event. He was inspired to do it, but also it provoked a big transformational process before doing this thing. And just in the perfect timing, he was able to emerge from this sort of accelerated bout of shadow work and step onto that stage free, anew, awake, and empowered. And I watched him perform at better than I've ever seen him. More comfortable, more in the flow, more fluid, really enjoying the journey. And now he's got that referent experience of, this is who I am. This is the new level I'm at. But understand, prior to those experiences, usually for most of us, is an emotional catharsis, a bout of shadow work, old energies coming up to be released, old fears, as I mentioned. And there can be a bit of a, yeah, like a bit of a dark night of the soul sometimes that come right before you step into this new version. But step into this new version, you shall. It is the time, it's a summer of expansion. A part of that expansion is the contraction. But the more you contract, the more and the further, the more expressive you get to expand into this new version of yourself. So what does that mean for you? Where are you feeling guided to go in life? What excites you? What lights you up with joy and passion? Regardless of how you're feeling right now, you can trust that excitement. And though it might take some courage, it might take some self-reflection and journaling or whatever works for you, but now is the time where you get to watch yourself step into this new version of yourself. I've shared many times before, but it's kind of ironic that I make YouTube videos considering just how shy and introverted and insecure I used to be. When it was time to present in front of the class, I was the one, you know, bullshitting my mom saying I'm sick, I can't go to school. I'd rather fail that than torture myself with that because my face would turn red, I would sweat. And like earlier, my YouTube career was so hard, you have no idea what would go on for these videos to come out. So they seem easily, but you don't know. Some of them I took many, many takes. Some of them it's like, I can't even explain some of the drama I would go through to put out these videos. But after a while, it became not only easy, but fun. I can just turn this camera on and just talk, and I love it. And that's what it means to step into that new higher version of yourself. And you'll get to have that as well. Maybe this new thing you're feeling called to do is new, and it might intimidate you. You might think, I don't know if I'm ready for that. And in the beginning, it might fumble a little bit. It's okay. In the beginning, it might be more stressful than it will eventually. But if you just step forward, you get to really see what you're actually made of. Thank you for watching, my friends. Have an amazing day. Much love.